Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release August 2023 as part of Catch Up with Nags series. What's new in this release and what are the exciting features what we get from Power BI team? Let's try to understand it. Before heading to today's video, this channel contains a lot of free contents that covers Power BI completely. And also it deals with SQL, data warehouse, SSIS, which is required for building your data warehouse technologies. Please utilize this free content and share this channel with your friends and colleagues. Let's begin. So we have the Power BI August 2023 features. As you can see, it was very limited updates. I hope they are focusing on Fabric side. So coming to some of the updates, right? The features, what I like most is like now there is no specific feature that I frequently use. So I don't think I like it in this part of release. But one thing I'll really going to try out exciting me is like XMLA write support for direct lake datasets. So this is what I like the most as part of this release. And let's try to go through one by one. Now, new layout switcher, what it is, once you download the August 2023 version, you will get some switcher, right? Switch between desktop and the mobile layout so that you can easily design your visuals over here. That is the layout switcher and new bubble range scaling settings, which is nothing but you can usually in the bubble or scatter charts, what happens is like the bubble size remains same based on the some options. So now you have range scaling based on the magnitude or the date range. So that you can set it up right now. So that is another update. On object interaction preview, typically like I'm not using this on object interaction, to be frank. I mean, because I'm so familiar with the old way of building the things. So this is like they keep on updating this on object interaction. I hope once it is settled down with all the easy features, then we can come back and create a new video on this. But what is this update is all about? Basically, you can see resizing and positioning to the object on object menus. You can see earlier if you have an object at the bottom of the page, it have a scroll bar. Now they made it as a full screen. I mean, it will not have a scroll bar and all. You can able to drag and drop easily. That is the you can add the objects from here. That is what the improvement they're saying about. And supported spotlight on focus mode. As I said, we will have a dedicated video on what are the pros and cons of on object interaction. We'll skip it for now. Then this is another important update. Like if you are using order by class, order by function in your DAX queries, there is something like updates of order by class. You can use the descending blanks last. So usually if certain member of your dimension or whatever columns you are selecting contains the blanks where it should be displayed, whether it should be displayed at the beginning or at the end, that is by ascending or descending. I mean, that is what, right? Here it is saying like descending blanks last, descending blank first. So that option you can mention it here. That is was the update about order by class or order by function. Basically, there is no class in DAX. It's everything is a function. So then going to here, lakehouse connectivity. So this update includes significant performance improvements. So you may be aware of the lakehouse connectors. I mean, Power BI can able to connect many sources. So one of the sources lakehouse, they have updated that one as well. This is the exacting feature I'm saying about. Like we have got XMLA write support for direct lake datasets. So XMLA write support is there for other source or datasets that has some other connections, but it doesn't support it for direct link data sets. So now it will support. This is one of the very good improvement from Microsoft Teams, so that you can use XMLA connectivity using any of the tools that mostly I use SSMS or tablet editor. So using any other tools what you trying to connect, you can use it. That is what this update is all about. And when you see a mobile, choose your startup content. Yes, this is also something I can say, those who are using it mobile, using Power BI in the mobile, usually like when you open a page, you are about to navigate to one page or one report, dashboard or app, right? But it will not be open default. So you can set it as a launch item, so that as soon as you open your mobile app in your Power BI, you can see it immediately, instead of navigating to the whatever you are interested in. So that is what this change is about. For that, you need to navigate to that item, and you can click on three ellipses at the top. Then you can make it as set as launch item. Then it will be at the beginning of your page. As soon as you log in. That is what another feature. Then I like one of the chat features here, that is as well editor speak as well. This is, I think, a Sunburst Chart by Power BI Wizard. This is gives you more of information. If you are familiar with the Sunburst, you can see it's similar kind of a pie chart or donut charts, but it will have circle or sunburst, right? It looks like a sunburst, so that is why it is called as Sunburst Chart. And there are a lot of business use cases you can use for using this Sunburst Charts. And finally, this X Wizard Performance Flow by Lumen. So this is again from XWiz. There are a lot of visuals available from XWiz as custom visuals, so you can use this one. So there are few improvements or performance flow by Lumen, right? So this will ensure that you can track your performance against the various KPIs in your organization. So what are those? Organization performance, and you can track the process flows, financial performance, sales performance. So you can explore these options as well. So that's it about August 2023 update. I will see you all in another video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. So do remember that data is your asset.